Let's go to the chart here and show the relative differential of an American bank. Well run. Francine will talk to Fortress Diamond today. Let's take the summer of 2017. We're on a normalized basis. JP Morgan, Barclays, and Deutsche Bank were bundled in together. JP Morgan was solid relative performance. Barclays managing the message, and Deutsche Bank doesn't have a message as well. Are you going to make some news today and tell me Barclays is one of your shorts, or is that not cricket?
Not cricket.
Damn. Okay, well, I tried. Okay, but you got some UK banks that you're not happy with now. Is it a profitability issue? Is it a revenue issue? Is it a management issue? Or is it just they can't compete with Fortress Diamond?
Look, the European banks generally, I think, have impaired business models because they're still 1.5 to 2 times more levered than U.S. banks, and they're less profitable. So I think over the long term, if you want to make a bet, you know, you could buy J.P. Morgan and short most of the European banks, and you'd be fine over the long term. My bet on the U.K. banks is really just a Brexit play.
It's just a Brexit.
It's a Brexit
right now.
Yeah.
Can you explain why sterling went up with the chaos and the meltdown we saw yesterday? I mean, these are odd and wonderful things, but are you surprised by the advancement of the currency given what we've seen?
I'm a bit surprised in the sense that none of the outcomes here are great for the UK. If you get a long delay, that's going to mean who's going to invest in the UK if there's, let's say, a 20-month delay over Brexit. And no company I know is going to put money into the UK in that period until they have certainty about what the end result's going to be. And since no one can seem to coalesce around any solution whatsoever in the UK, I think long term this is negative for the UK one way or the other. It's just a matter of degree.